But if the ancient starlings have lived here for so long, that means the cleansing somehow couldn't harm them.
Correct. And yet, they never helped any of the civilizations that were extinguished by it.
True.
But why? This is murder! If they know how to defend themselves against the High Ones, why didn't they share that knowledge?
Who knows? Maybe their hands were tied somehow.
Maybe they connected to the High Ones in some way. That's a pretty poor excuse for letting dozens of civilizations be murdered.
Don't jump to conclusions. Have you ever wondered where the plans for the beacon came from?
Yeah, I thought it was the
Pyreans. As Arendiel said, its technology shares a lot of similarities with Kermai's starship. So maybe they did do something after all.
Yeah, I've heard that argument.
But that's just speculation. What we do know is that neither the Red Madness, the High Ones, nor the cleansing could harm them, and that their knowledge might be the key to completing the beacon.
Oh!
Look at that! Welcome to the memories of the ancient fathers. Let's see what we can learn from it. If the Grandmaster was right about this, the Pyrean history should perfectly reflect the different phases of
people
the cycle,
falling.
Including the cleansing.
People falling. Examine the old reliefs for similarities to Vin's history. Oh no, I have a torch.
The sixth step. The cycle concludes.
Oh, this is the
cleansing
end.
Happens, and mankind vanishes, just like that.
Let's start
with the
first
one. You see this temple in the background? This must be the temple in the City of a Thousand Floods, the heart of the Pyrean realm.
Alright, well let's start with this one. Ancient man?
That's the first step of the cycle. Out of nothing, life forms itself. And from that life, man evolves and starts populating the Earth.
Right. Lost one. Buildings on fire, farms.
The second step of the cycle, just as the Grandmaster said. A first civilization arises, blossoms, and falls. For us, it was Asadaron's reign of the Eterna, which collapsed after Starfall. Who knows what it was in the Age of the Pyreans?
And the third step? The worshipping of the Lightborn?
That's... let me see... Yes, this is the creation of a theocracy. After the first civilization falls, a second one arises, that is reigned over by a few who proclaim themselves gods. Do you see the hats? These were the Sun Priests of the Pyrean realm, the equivalent of our Lightborn.
Right. Alright, fourth step. War. War and death.
That's step number four, the downfall of the rulers. For us, it was the Shadow God and Narazul Aranthiel who killed the Lightborn. In the Pyrean Age, it was this general, Jakal. He was
right.
A member of one of the reigning castes himself, but one day turned against them. The Archmagister told me all about it. He was the Pyrean Shadow God and the Pyrean Tauranar Quarak, all in one, so to speak.
Alright, and then the fifth... Is that the Veiled Woman?
The chaos, the war, the red madness.
Right.
This is the fifth step, where we are right now. Do you see this shape in the background? This must be the High Ones, who are behind all of it. The cycle nears its end. And after the sixth step, it all starts over. So this is the final proof. Everything that has happened to the Pyreans, and probably to those before them too, is now happening to us.
Well, we knew that already. But how exactly does that help us find the Numenos?
That's the question, but... by the gods.
What?
Malthus bless mankind. It ascends to the sky. To the High Ones. Mankind doesn't vanish at the end of a cycle. It becomes a high one.
What? That's what the Naramese are thinking, but... What? How do you get that out of this? Unless you're thinking they're ascending, not descending. Why would they... Right. Why would they be coming out of the sky like that?
That is how they reproduce. How they feed, or whatever you wish to call it. Don't you see?
What?
These shapes that ascend skywards. They're thoughts, our consciousness, our souls. And all of them together form a new high one.
Oh, but we're not
so
us.
So you are saying that what a high one really is the consciousness of an entire civilization?
Yes. It's our memories, our thoughts, our dark knowledge, our collective consciousness.
So they absorb us.
This is monstrous.
So it's not what the Naramese think. It's not each of us turns into a high one, we're all absorbed into one high one. So every high one that exists is the remnant of an entire civilization. So you've got one high one out there that's the collection of all the Pyreans that ever existed. And you've got another high one that's about to be born, which is going to be made out of us. And then there's other high ones that are made out of whatever other civilizations. How many high ones are there? How many civilizations have been destroyed? That's what the cleansing really is, then. The creation of a high one from an entire civilization?
Yes. Yes, by the righteous path, that's it. Korik is right. In a way, humanity does reach a new level of existence because it becomes one of those beasts.
We don't remain ourselves. Even knowing all that still doesn't help us. We still don't know what this Numenos is. Or where it is.
Oh, yes, we do. The Word of the Dead. You said the aged man left it for you, didn't you?
Well, I don't have it anymore, but yes, but why?
Then this is the way. The Numenos. I know what it is. Or rather, what we need to fill it with.
Fill it?
The essence of a high one.
The essence of a high one? Well, I don't know how we'd get that, and what makes you think that?
It's hard to explain. The problem with the High Ones is that they don't have a physical shape, and this makes it hard to fight them. They are everywhere and nowhere, just like the air. This is why we need the beacon to fight it. It has the power to banish them.
Because it's the counterpart to the High Ones. Well, that's old news, but what makes you think a High One's essence is what the Numenos needs to be filled with?
It's an assumption, but a well-grounded one. What the beacon does is channel massive amounts of energy and unleash it on its core. Isn't it logical, then, that we need something of what we want to banish? Like an energy signature inside it. It might sound far-fetched to you, but it feels right.
It feels right is hardly a good basis upon which to make such an important decision.
You're correct. It is not. But I don't see that we have any alternatives. Do you?
No, not really. So even if this is true, how are we supposed to get our hands on the essence of a high one?
Well, this is where it gets complicated. But I think I also have an answer to that. The Word of the Dead.
You just mentioned
that. We need to use it on a high one. To enter its mind.
Really?
If there is any place we can find a High One's essence, it is there.
But even if that would work, where are we supposed to find a High One? You said it yourself, Magistrate. They don't have a physical form, and even if they had, they surely wouldn't reveal themselves to us.
That is correct. But I know where to find one.
You do? Where is that?
Where the last cleansing took place. That is where we need to go. And once we are there, you need to listen to the echo.
Of course. You can see what happened back then.
Correct. The echo grants you the ability to feel and relive the memories of this world.
But since the High Ones are immaterial and will not reveal themselves to us when we want them to, all we can do is travel back to a point where they did. The last cleansing, where the Pyreans became one of them.
You want to use the word of the dead on this High One to enter its mind and steal its essence? I mean, maybe it could work, maybe when it's first created, or born, lack of a better term. That's when it's most vulnerable. Maybe that's the only time you could do something like that. When it's weak and new. So we're gonna enter its mind and steal its essence.
Yes. This means that we have to find the holy city of the Pyreans, where the last cleansing took place. The City of Floods.
Oh. What makes you think the Word of the Dead will work on a memory? I thought it can only enter the minds of the deceased.
Yes, but we just learned that devouring us is what allows the High Ones to create a new one of their own. In other words, death is what a High One consists of. It's a giant, sentient, and ethereal corpse in a way.
Good God.
If the Word of the Dead doesn't work on them, it shouldn't work on anything. At least, that is one way to see it. Let us hope I'm right.
Okay, so where are we supposed to find this City of Floods?
Well, I hope this place can help us find the answer. If the ancient starlings witnessed the entire cycle of the Pyreans, then they surely knew a lot about the geography of the world as it was back then as well. We need to keep searching. Come, let us go back to the tower.
Entities who reproduce by devouring the consciousness of an entire civilization? That's just bizarre.
Can't move.
Is it? Don't we ourselves breed pigs so that we may eat them once they're fat enough? In a way, the High Ones are just like us, except that it's our thoughts that they are after rather than our bodies. It bears a certain kind of logic. You cannot deny that.
It's evil.
Knowing that, Korak's story about mankind ascending to another level isn't as far-fetched as it first sounded. We don't cease to exist. We coalesce into something else. Into a High One.
It's not the way he thought.
Yes, but is this new High One really us? Or does it just need us to come forth? Yes, we know now that this is how they reproduce. But we still know far too little. How did they come into being? How long has this been going on? So many questions.
True, but if I may say so, Magistrat, we should save the philosophical questions for after we have stopped the cleansing.
Of course.
Well, we can still wonder. I mean, just waiting for this thing to go up. This thing's open to the sky. I didn't realize that.
Well then, let's see what...
Kermai?
They are here! They have been here all along!
Kermai! Where by the righteous path were you?
He was a fool to bring you here.
Where is
you
he?
You soil-born are too dangerous. You've always been.
Soil?
But he was too blinded. Blinded by his dream to finally finish her and sail home.
I don't like this, Magistra.
Me neither.
What are you talking about, Kermai? The fact that the ancient starlings left this city doesn't have anything to do with us.
Stop talking! Darn it, you are so ignorant! They are here, but they won't reveal themselves to us because they don't accept your presence.
You sure about that?
Because you are unworthy of them.
The Magister is one of the most capable Arcanists on Enderal. If this were some kind of illusion, she would have seen through it by now.
Nonsense! Even your mightiest of magics is child's play compared to the ancient technology.
Well, that didn't work.
He will prove his worth to them. He will show that he deserves to live among them. The soil-born have to die. And then the fathers will reveal themselves.
No, die.
But how?
Kermai, stop this! Right now!
The defense system, of course!
Yes.
No defense system.
They will understand.
I don't understand.
To arms.
To arms. We're gonna be attacked by stuff? I can't use my ghost here. Oh, I don't wear a talisman. That's why! I don't have a talisman on. Duh, I forgot to put that. All my clothes got changed after... well, we had our intimate moment. Talisman Lorem. Of course I can't.
It has to be done.
Whoa. Forgotten Homeland Part 3. Okay. Steel Dragon? We learned two things in the Star City. Was that it up there? First of all, the cleansing is the event in which the High Ones absorb the collective consciousness of a civilization to create a new High One from it. Secondly, the Numenos is the consciousness of a High One. Magister Yela assumes that we can get one by using the Word of the Dead, which the aged man left behind, most likely in the City of a Thousand Floods where the cleansing of the Pyreans happened. But as we left the archive, we met a hysterical Kermai. He blamed us for the disappearance of the ancient fathers and set off an alarm, which cost both his and Magister Yela's life. Oh. They both died? Oh my god. Now it's up to us to find a map to the City of the Thousand Floods and escape from the Star City. Oh my god. Ow. Are we even in combat? Okay, I guess we just supposed to go out this way. Okay. There's a steel dragon. Oh! Have one of these. Sorry, Lorem.
That was all of them, I think.
That was just one spider and...
What happened up there? The Magistra. She didn't deserve that.
She definitely didn't. So it's just. Well, before it was a spider and a Starling Centurion. Kermai seems to have activated some kind of alarm. These machines, they must have been designed to defend the city. That can't be all of them, though.
Yes, of course. But what now, Saira? We now know what the Numenos is, but. We still need a map to help us find the City of a Thousand Floods. And surviving these creatures will be a challenge, too.
There will be more. What about the airship? We need to warn Jespar and Lijem.
Yes, you're right. We do. That means back to the dock. Come on, let's get back to that elevator.
Well, what about the map? Escape from the Steel Dragon. Did I miss this big battle with a Steel Dragon? Okay, maybe the map is not here. Because it's not saying that we have to find a map. Just... oh!
So much for that.
Yeah, that's pretty impassable. So we need to find another way back down.
Let's look around.
Something tells me it's over this way. Or maybe...
She was already a keeper long before the Grandmaster was even born.
Yeah.
It's just not fair.
I know.
Saira?
I know, it's not fair, I agree. What can you do? I feel like something's right here for some reason. We need to find another way. Botanicum? Wait. Okay. He went bye-bye. You pulled a chain before. Was that in this room? I can't remember. Oh, I found a chain. Wait, here. Okay, that's not doing anything. If only I could fly. I'd grab you and we'd just go up. Any other chain? What? Okay, there's a little lever hidden here. It took me a while to find this. I'm gonna cut out my endless wanderings, at least some of it. When did that open? That way?
Good. Let us hope it also leads us down the tower.
Yes, let's hope. Botanicum. Are you sneaking too? Because now I'm sure there'll be baddies. Find a way to return. Sorry about that. Oops. Up there. So it's very close. I think it's up on that overhang. Oh look! Standard health potion and a chest. All these coins. I don't know what I'm gonna do with them, but I got some. I can hear them, but I don't see them. I see one, actually. Damn it. Here's one. Damn it. I could have finished that one off. I could have been a contender. Stand still. Damn it, he's too far away right now. We have to eventually go that way. I think we're gonna have to go down and back up. Gotcha. Favorite combat song. I can't hit that. We do have to go down and back up. That's one right there. Yep.
That was all of them.
You two are a pretty good team. coins. Oh. Of course there's not. There's more.
There.
This time it was all me. Not a fun guy. Is that a nice claw? It is a nice claw. I did to you, putty tat. Total weight, 453. I can carry a lot more stuff. So give me some stuff. I'm guessing that the Starlings did not call that Malphus Flower. That's just the name we have for them. I see you. Damn it. It moved. That feels great, doesn't it? Oh, there's spiders too. You okay?
There.
I think I hit you, sorry. Oh, it also tells us Kalia's health. That's pretty awesome. So we need to get back up. Any in the water or something? Probably not. Figure they would rust, you know, but what do I know? I hear that. That's a centurion somewhere up there, I think. Oh no, he's right there. Damn it. So good at finding out where we were. Grand Soul Gem, Lube. Else over here. Hey! You're pushing me. Normally I wouldn't mind, but I'm pushed into a dresser isn't exactly my idea of a good time. That's our way up. We're supposed to go that way. It sounds like the footsteps are from below. There's a chest over there. I missed that. I gotta go back for that. Alright, so we're going that way. Jeez. $167 coins. There's a spider there. I wasn't able to reach him, or he's too tiny from that far away. Best to hit you at a distance so you don't damage our person. There's a chest here. Starling stuff makes sense. Blueprints. Okay. Yeah, I missed it and there was two ways up here. Or was there? Yeah. Two ways. So that, where does this go then? Oh. Sure AI below? Oh, we can't open it. That's where all the developers hang out, isn't it? They've locked it. Alright, we'll go this way. That's where they have their little developer parties and stuff like that.
Kirosh.
Are we safe out here from
that
stuff?
Doesn't look good.
What happened? Oh, yeah! Where is the ship?
I don't know.